Hello everyone, back with Horizon Dawn, Frozen Wilds, and hopefully I can wrap the DLCs up here soon. So, just gonna
Lodge is
jump right
well stocked,
into it, and we're
as you
gonna
asked. And
talk
our
to
scouts are
our
watching for
attack.
more frost
I
crops,
never
but our
know
purpose
how to
was to take
pronounce
back
his
the
name.
mountain. Now what?
Stay prepared. Sharpen your spears. Should we not return, defending the cut falls to you. If our chieftain agrees with this course.
Sounds like good advice, but let's hope it doesn't come to that.
Chieftain?
The weight of command is no small burden.
I can see that.
No, we have all these warriors.
I take it you haven't spoken to Araya yet?
Why should I?
Is this gonna
this
be
is
a
what
three?
She wanted. To return to Thunder's Drum. It is her only care. So I should have known she would find a way to push aside my spear. After the Karja took my sister, not all of her came back.
Man,
tell me what
are
happened to the first
huge
expedition.
Dicks.
Raya led the way to the summit, but it was blocked by a great door, some kind of cauldron, new metal. We tried to break through, but it was unflinching. We were exhausted, no way forward, and machines behind. I made the call to push back. It cost us greatly. But to remain would have cost us everything. I had hoped to never subject Araya to that again.
What happened to Araya when she was a captive of the Karja?
As a shaman, she's adept with machines. Tracking them, stunning them. The Karja used her to capture them for the Sun Ring. Where they were unleashed upon the innocent. They made her part of their blood sport. The shame she suffered beneath their pitiless sun.
She survived.
She endured. Endured by reminding herself of the spirit, her purpose. And now that's all she has.
What do you think is beyond that door?
I do not know. That expanse of metal, that dead hum. Nothing sacred belongs there. Machines and death, that's what the mountain holds. Death for us or for the daemon.
And if we do find the spirit,
then perhaps we should put it out of its misery.
For what it's worth, I'm glad you're coming with me.
Someone has to keep Araya safe.
Let us hope Kokolai takes care of the murderer quickly.
None of the southern tribes rival
Lucas. Yeah, not. Lord knows what. Oh, Lord knows what's waiting for me.
Aloy, this is it. My chance to reunite with the spirit, and perhaps to reunite her with the blue light. It's not a chance I would have had alone. I needed an outsider. Someone ignorant of our ways, but no, not ignorant. I...
Are you trying to thank me, Araya?
Yes, of course. That's what you do. Untangle knots. Create possibilities. Thank you for making this pilgrimage possible. I only wish it had not been necessary.
Yeah, what would this world do without Aloy?
You were wise to let him come. He's earned the right. Stubborn as stone, but he's had to be. The war demanded it. And so have I.
Bartok told me you were a captive of the Carja for a long time. It sounded bad.
For Aratak, it all comes back to that. He thinks the Carja changed me. They did not. They merely sharpened my focus. When all else is lost, you think about what's truly important. The spirit. The blue light. The beyond. And my brother, too. Every time I felt the chill northern wind, I thought of him. Worried for him.
What did the war do to Aratak?
He cut away everything, until only his true self remained. Unyielding ice. Nobunoka's more sheer will. He fought the Carja for 1,000 freezing nights, yet always rallied his hunters at sunrise. It is said he endured 23 wounds in those years. His hunters counted them. He never complains of one. Instead, he complains that life with me is harder. He's right. What have I ever given him but struggle?
Now that I'm
all things considered,
chief doesn't have the Werak.
These two sound like
you to tell me about silence.
Like
Aratak would never have presumed to grasp for a secret of the Conclave, but you are not Aratak, and if you have dealt with silence, your need is well apparent. Silence came to Bon Or from the distant north, a young shaman of the Owl's Watch, a remote Werak that rarely comes south to parley.
Silence was a shaman.
It was. Or at least, when we sent runners to ask the Owl's Watch, they said he was. His knowledge of the machines was beyond compare, and he was hungry to trade what he knew to the rest of us. It didn't take him long to gain the trust of the Conclave, and eventually, an invitation to attend.
What about you? Did you trust him?
No. But he impressed me. He carried himself with poise and authority. I wanted to learn from him, but that was not to be. He was granted knowledge of our most sacred meeting place, the frozen caves of the Malmstrom, a month's march from Bon Or. He met with us there, as is custom at high winter. But when we next returned, the caves had been looted. Relics of the old world stolen, holes cut in ice and metal.
Yeah, that'd be silence, all right.
He vanished with the spoils. We sent our best trackers after him. None returned. And when we checked back with the Owl's Watch, those who had vouched for him were gone. As though he never existed. Some in the Conclave began to doubt he was even Banuk to begin with.
And what do you think?
He committed an unforgivable sacrilege. He's unscrupulous and dangerous. But also brilliant, skilled, and knowledgeable without equal. Except, perhaps, for you. Anyone else I would warn off, but you may be able to treat with him safely. Just don't lower your guard.
I'll keep that in mind, Horea. Thanks. What are we gonna find up there, Horea?
Ruins. Machines.
Silence kind of a dick.
Like that of a cauldron.
I mean, pretty much no
doubt. I have faith
that
you can find a way through it, Aloy. For beyond it lies the spirit. I know I can find her there. Though I do not doubt the daemon has tried to hide.
Sounds like he does whatever he needs to get what he wants.
It hasn't been easy for you, Aurea. Getting back to this point.
It was all to hear her voice again. This time, we both will.
I'd like that.
Are you ready, then? Once we ascend, it'll be hard to turn back.
Finally, we ascend. How? I don't see a way up.
Not up. Through.
Now, brother!
You know, it hasn't been that long since you guys went the first time. It's kind of crazy that it's already frozen over.
Too can call upon the power of the old ones.
It's funny she thinks that an emergency evacuation thing is her.
The spirit once told me that this all used to be part of its domain. A fortress that defended humankind from terrible danger.
Fortress? It looks more like a machine.
Is that not fitting? Blue light often dwells in machines.
Well, let's just hope that some remains here. Metal pillars, tall as those cliffs. I still don't like it. Here, up and over.
Once these halls rang with the spirit's presence.
So maybe. Ugly biped machine. Little bit closer. Little bit. Stop. climb up anywhere. I cannot. Yeah, damn it. I hate bellowbacks. It's not even that I like hate the machine. I hate, like, the best way to take them out is obviously to take out their containers. But that back container is a pain in the ass to shoot sometimes. And I understand if they made it that way, but damn. That scrapper is just a little too close for comfort. I don't know, sometimes I'll think I'm in the clear and then all of a sudden it's like, oh, he saw me on the corner of his eye while he was looking up. Hate it. God, they're just, I hate when they group together like that. Get away, no one wants you. I think I should be fine, honestly. Killing him. I don't think the scrapper will see me. Stab! What? I am the knight! Okay, yeah. Scrapper didn't see. Oh, but the bellowback heard. Yeah. I call bullshit. Bullshit. Whatever. Nothing to see. Okay. Should be able to kill this thing without him seeing. Stab! Got two down. No! In fact, if you do nothing, that would be awesome. Actually be able to do this. Stab! Stab! Stabby stab stab. Is that a bird? That's weird how you can turn on the shit. Nothing to see. Go away. Okay, that didn't work as well as I wanted it to. Like, that only took a small chunk of health out. You guys got this. You guys totally got this. that's that one. Shit. Well, fuck you. Okay. Ah, shit. Shit. I got this, guys. I got this. There we go. See? Surprisingly, it went well. Usually, these stealth parts I am terrible at, so. Everything's coming up, Aloy. That's a data point, that's what I thought it was.
Not much farther now.
What kind of shit am I gonna get drawn into? Oh, this looks promising. This looks inviting and warm.
Last we were here, we fought our way through there. The machines overcame us. We retreated, dropping supplies and taking losses. Now we must prevail, with only two warriors and a shaman to protect.
Aloy is no ordinary warrior. And I can hold my own. And so, we could go that way instead. There are machines up there, but also cover. We could stay hidden, just for a while.
So head on attack, or
right.
Cover.
Now follow my lead.
Honestly, I think I'll take the cover because I don't want to run out of resources. I mean, I have a lot of resources, but I don't feel like going through all my resources. So I'm gonna take the easy way. Well, not the easy way, but I'm gonna take the stealth way. Closer. Stabby. That didn't kill you? Oh, damn it. Ah, what the hell? What happened to the critical hit? Alright, cool. Everything's good, nothing saw us. Shit, they saw us. They got this. See, they got this. I ain't gotta help them. They got this. Oh, fuck. Search the dead body. In the leg. Get the leg meat. Oh shit. Critical strike. What? What is going on with my critical strike? Critical hit, whatever it's called. Oh shit. It's like I I guess it makes you wait a second before doing it. Can I please search the dead body? Thank you. In the force. Oh shit. Oh, the invisible bastards are here. I hate the invisible bastards. They are the most annoying. They're most annoying in a enclosed space because they have a lot of places to hide. They're out in the open. It's not so hard. Die. Just die. Ow. Heal. Aw, damn it. A chicken. That's what I think about that. You know what'd have been cool? A cool arrow to do? A cool arrow would have been like one that stops them from using their abilities for a specific amount of time. Why did I get the caster? Anyways. Or maybe there is an arrow that does that, and I just don't know, and I need to heal. Okay. Not as successful as last time, but hey, I'm getting there. I'm still chugging along, still living.
There's frost between my teeth.
There's a door up ahead, in refuge. We're almost through.
More data points. All the data points. I want them all. Oh boy. There's a box back there. Check the box. What's in the box?
No space.
That's not a played out reference at all. Anywho, so I'm gonna call this part quits. Hopefully be getting to the end of this DLC. I think I only have like a half an hour to 40 minutes left, so I don't know, we'll see. So thanks for watching. I'll see you guys next time.